Today we're gonna see how you can easily create in Final Cut Pro 10 a freeze frame intro. For those of you who are watching me for your first time, I'm Emilio Takas and I post videos here on tutorials, filmmaking tips, gear reviews and much more. So if you're into this kind of stuff, consider subscribing to my channel and also ring the notification bell to receive notifications every time I post a new video. Without any further ado, let's hop into Final Cut Pro 10 and see how we can create this effect. We are in the Final Cut Pro 10 and I have placed the video that we will work on today. The first step is to find the exact time spot that we will create the freeze frame. Here, let's see, here, okay, we're pressing Option F on our keyboard and we're grabbing this with the Alt and the left click and we're duplicating above. Now we will go into the generators and we'll select the custom solid color and we will place it under our duplicated frame so we can make the background darker. We're lowering the opacity and we go to the effects panel, we type on the search mask, we will grab the draw mask and we're starting drawing our mask. Take your time here, more details, it's gonna have a better result in the end. When we finish with our mask, we see that the background is darker. Now we will play with the feather and the follow on the inspector panel on the right. And when we are satisfied with the result, we're gonna take this layer which has the draw mask on it with Option on our keyboard and left click on our mouse, duplicate it and bring it below. Now we go to the effects panel, on the color we select colorize, we place it on the layer below and we select the color into white. We will make the intensity 100%. And after that we select the two layers and we go in the inspector panel into transfer. We will go in the beginning of the clip, we're gonna place a keyframe on scale all and go to the end of the clip and we're gonna raise the scale in about 122 and time to check to see what we've done so far. Now we're gonna make the layer below to be bigger so we can create a feeling of a stroke underneath our draw mask layer. So we're playing around with the scale on the transform, the position and the general feeling that we're gonna have underneath the layer. And once we're satisfied with the result, let's play and see how our freeze frame intro is right now. Perfect, and now it's time for my favorite effect, the Bat TV. We go into the effects panel, we search for Bat TV, we grab it and we place it on the white draw mask. We're gonna adjust the amount at about 8 and we're gonna select white noise. And it starts to getting a lot better. Now we're gonna grab a Splash PNG image, you can find the link to download it in the description down below the video. And we're gonna create an opposite transform now, so instead of zooming in, we're gonna zoom out in the Splash element and we're gonna select the composite into Darken. We've made the initial scale to 177%, so we're placing a keyframe in the beginning of the layer and at the end we're gonna scale to about 115%. And we're gonna grab again the Bat TV effect and we're gonna place it into the background below and we're gonna select the TV static with a percentage at around 16% and let's see what we have. Perfect. And now it's time to place our titles. So We're closing the effects panel and we're pressing Ctrl T to insert the title. We select our title and we're gonna type the letters that we want. I will rotate it a little bit right here. And now I'm gonna make the title to come from the left. So I'm going into the position, I'm bringing all the way to the left, I'm placing a keyframe. And then I go into the position of my clip that I want the title to appear. And I bring back to the right the position. Also, I want it to be behind my subject. And as you can see, Ted is coming from the left. Perfect. We're gonna do the same so we can place a starring, let's say, in the title. So we'll continue with the same process. Control T to insert the title. We're typing our words, starring. We're adjusting the font. And I'm gonna make a starring appearing from the top. So I'm grabbing it and putting it on top, placing the keyframe into position. And I'm finding the right spot where it will land. And I will bring the position, I will bring it back to where I want it to be, on top of Ted. Perfect. Let's watch to see what we have. Now I'm gonna go to the inspector panel and I'm gonna play some drop shadow on Ted and Starring, my two titles. And we're done. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up as it helps a lot to my channel. And if you have any questions, put them down in the comments below and I'll reply to them as soon as I can. Thank you so much for watching and I will see you in the next one.